Hey guys, welcome to this Laravel technique video. In this one, we're going to take a look at how to build this cookie pop-up over here in the left-hand corner. If you're not familiar with cookies, they're basically used to manage user sessions, personal preferences, and to track any kind of user behavior. Now, there's many ways to implement a cookie pop-up or cookies. So I'm going to take a really straightforward approach with this one using Laravel 9 and some packages. So we'll get you started. And we'll also have some functionality where we can try to like click away and close this thing if you stick around for the end of the tutorial. Okay, thanks for jumping in. Let's get started. All right, let's start with a bit of housekeeping first. So what I've done is I've installed a default copy of Laravel and I've also implemented Jetstream. And you can check that out on the channel. Just watch some of the videos that I've posted before and that will get you all caught up. So the only thing different in this project versus a normal Laravel project is that we have node modules installed here. We have in our resources directory, we have views and you know all the other files that comes with the starter kit. In addition, in the env file, you're going to need to configure some sort of database, possibly you know with your user root and password. Check out the videos on installing MySQL, also on this channel. And the other nice thing that it does is that it installs Webpack and sets it up for you and requires Tailwind, which we're going to need for this plugin. And lastly, the tailwindconfig.cs file is just set up here with the Jetstream starter kit. Okay, if you were to view the application in a URL in the browser, you will see this. My TLD is slightly different. It is, you know, .code, but be sure to check out those Valley tutorials, guys, to get caught up. So when it's all ready to go, you should have something like this in the browser. So now we're gonna open the resources directory and we're gonna drop down here to views. And we're gonna look inside of this folder here called layouts. What we're gonna do is we're gonna create a file here and the file is gonna be called site. So we're gonna create like a template for the rest of the page. To do so, we're just going to cd into resources and just following the same path structure, we're going to jump into views, right? And then we're going to jump into layouts and then we're going to go in here. Then we're going to use the touch command and we're going to create a file called site.blade.php. And this is just a blank file, but we're going to use this to create a template for the welcome page that we're going to attach later on. Okay, so we'll close this for now. Next up, we're just going to jump right to the top here and we're going to go to the app directory and we're going to go inside view. And these are basically view components. So these are components that we're going to use to attach this file here, this layout to this component. And then we're going to serve it up in another welcome blade, which is down here. And the welcome blade is just basically the scaffold that you see when you create a project. So the content that resides here.
What do you mean I left the video on? Oh, snap. Yo, I gotta go. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna get back to work and you guys get back to the video. Okay, they're still there. All right, I'm going.
So we're gonna go back to this and we're gonna right click components directory and we're gonna create a new class. The class is gonna have the namespace app view components and we're going to call this one site and layout. And then we're gonna hit accept. And it's going to create this class for us. So since this class is inside of the components directory, we're just going to extend this right here and we're going to extend the components. And the specific one we're going to use is going to be illuminate. Okay, so we're going to use this one. All right, and we're going to get an error right now and that's okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to create the function that's going to render the layout. So it's going to render the content that's being represented by this component. So we'll start with public function and we're going to call the render method. And inside here, this is our to-do. We're going to implement the render method. And all that we're going to do is something pretty straightforward. We're just going to return the view. And in our case, the view is that file that we created, which is the layouts site. Okay, so that's this file right here that we, you know, we went into the terminal here and we created. Okay, hope that all makes sense. And this is not necessary, but old habits die hard, I guess. We're just going to add some doc blocks for our component or for our class. So once that's all done, nothing should change with the actual project itself. So once we refresh, you notice that it's still the same. And that's it for this one, guys. Don't forget to like the video if you found this useful. Leave your comments and thoughts below. Take care, and I will see you next time.